the most valuable currency that you will ever have in any situation is your ability to tell stories. You might be saying that the dollar is worth more than a story, or that blockchain or cryptocurrencies is going to be far more valuable, or that a company is more valuable than a story. But I argue that without a proper story, those companies' values would not be where they're at today. Story is by far the most valuable currency that you have. And if you can tell a story that relates to an individual, to your target demographic, whether it's in a movie or in a product you're selling, story is how you can connect to those people. It's a currency that we've been using ever since we could communicate, from drawings in caves, picture artwork, to the first novel, Beowulf, and all the way continuing to today and these micro content shared stories. It's a way in which humans have communicated throughout time. Having seen stories develop, but over time and to where they are today, it's a way in which people can remember and connect on that emotional level. Now, as a storyteller, that makes me super excited that story has such a profound impact on humans worldwide. You can tell a story in America, and that story may have elements that resonate with somebody in Thailand or in Russia, in South Africa, Brazil. Stories have this strange ability to be able to cross cultures and to cross demographics and generations. And that is why story is such a important and such a valuable currency. And if a brand is not embracing the idea of telling stories to connect with their target demographic, it just makes me scratch my head that they're missing out on this crazy opportunity to have their target, their audience, get behind them as a company, get behind them as a brand, and root for them because they connect on that level of, I feel that experience and I want to support you because we connect in that way. So story is far more than just a buzzword. In fact, it's not even a buzzword. Story is a way in which we can communicate. And the elements of modern day storytelling, you have a protagonist, you have an antagonist, and the protagonist has a goal. The antagonist does not want the protagonist to achieve their goal. In fact, their two goals are directly opposing each other. And at the end of the story, somebody achieves their goal, creating conflict, and both coming out on the other end different from where they started. It's an element of being able to see transformation in a person, because we as individuals transform on a daily basis. We start our day and we end our day in a different place. We start our day awake and we end our day tired. That's total transformation, the basic sense. We are in one spot and end in another. So story is so valuable, and I'm happy to say that it is the core of my company, the core of what I do as a content creator. And I'm so glad to be able to share story, and I'm so thankful that I was able to spend so many years and still spend all this time studying the elements of story and what makes story story. And the best part is, the tools to tell a good story are much more attainable than what a lot of people think. There isn't like a billion tools that you have to learn in order to achieve a quality story. In fact, you can tell a good story with far fewer tools than 500. Do you want to try and master 500 tools, or would you rather master 3 or 4? And then probably be better at storytelling as a whole than the person that's trying to master 500. Because good luck. I'll see you when you get it. Storytelling, a currency that is unrivaled in its value. The hardest part is understanding how to mine the value out of story.